Why is it that in the public school system, that every time the subject of black history is taught, it always begins in the 1600s and with slavery? Black history. According to the public school system, Negroes were brought to America in 1619, forced to work as slaves on plantations, until one day this great white man named Abraham Lincoln came along and felt bad for the slaves, and signed the Emancipation Proclamation in 1863, which freed the slaves. But there were still some bad whiteys in the southern states that passed Jim Crow laws for segregation. Afterwards, there came more whites that felt bad and then gave blacks civil rights in the 1960s, then allowed a black man to have the presidential office named Barack Obama. Now blacks are finally equal to whites. We can all get along. The end. Now, moving right along to our English lecture for the day. I don't think so.
This is the Bible in 1 minute, without the confusion of white supremacy. God is black. He made the world for one people, the Israelites. He declares his word to Jacob, his statutes and his judgments to Israel. He has not dealt thus with any nation. All this I have spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou hast made us the world for our sakes. As for the other people, which also come of Adam, thou hast said, they are nothing, but be like unto spit. God chose Israel over all the nations, and he gave them a choice. Turn away from sin and follow the law, or go into slavery.
We kept choosing sin.
You need to research this, and especially this.
Our ancestors were enslaved by the Egyptian, the Babylonian, the Assyrian, the Greeks, and the Roman. And this will be the last captivity, because Yeshaya is coming back. He will be a black man with a sword, not this guy, or this white guy, and especially this white guy.
These people know this, and they're pretending to be you. Return to the law and put your faith in Yeshaya, and we will rule in the next kingdom.
Prophet Isaiah Yehuda.
It comes as a great shock to discover that the country which is your birthplace and to which you owe your life and your identity has not in its whole system of reality evolved any place for you. It comes as a great shock around the age of 5 or 6 or 7 to discover the flag to which you have pledged allegiance along with everybody else has not pledged allegiance to you. It comes as a great shock to discover that Gary Cooper killing off the Indians when you were rooting for Gary Cooper, that the Indians were you. When I was growing up, I was taught in American history books that Africa had no history, and neither did I. That I was a savage, about whom the less said the better, who had been saved by Europe and brought to America. And of course, I believed it. I didn't have much choice. Those are the only books there were. I am stating very seriously, and this is not an overstatement, that I picked the cotton, and I carried its market, and I built the railroad under someone else's whip, for nothing. for nothing. If one has got to prove one's title to the land, isn't 400 years enough? 400 years, at least three wars. The American soil is full of the corpses of my ancestors. Why is my freedom or my citizenship or my right to live there? How is it conceivably a question now? What we are not facing is the results of what we've done. What one begs the American people to do for all our sakes is simply to accept our history until the moment comes when we, the American people, we are trying to forge a new identity for which we need each other. Until this moment, there is scarcely any hope for the American dream, because the people who are denied participation in it, by their very presence, will wreck it.
From the Igbo people, and while some people may brush this mask off, it's very relevant to his final words. In order to understand the connection, you have to understand an important moment during the slavery times regarding the Igbo people. In May 1803, there is an event called the Igbo Landing. After crossing the Middle Passage, a slave ship arrived in Georgia, intending to auction off multiple people taken from West Africa. Out of all those people, 75 of them were Igbo people, sold for about $100 each, and they were put onto another ship to be sent to their new location, but during this, they rebelled. Now, during the rebellion, the Igbo people took control of the ship and killed their captors, but with no way of returning home, and likely being recaptured and forced into slavery, even with this rebellion, the Igbo people in unison decided to commit suicide, choosing death over bondage. So as you can see, this definitely directly coincides with what Killmonger was saying. And I really just thought it was a really cool connection. Not cool as in like, oh, that's a really cool, like it looks cool, but more cool as in interesting. And if that was intentional, which I'm sure it was by Ryan Coogler and the rest of the writing team, definitely hats off to them, pat on the back to them, because that was brilliant. So while I found this connection really interesting, what did you guys think? Let me know in the comments below your thoughts. What did you think about Black Panther if you saw it? And with all this
change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
But I know